you walking and talking, no faking, creating. Hola, ¿cómo están? My love muffins and enchiladas. It's Tori, the whole dealer of guided intuition, and I have an important message from your soul. Hear ye, hear ye. Gather around, tribe, okay? I want to share something that happened to me Monday with the beautiful soul that is watching this video, because it ties in to this current energy that we are experiencing right now in this very moment. Whenever you are seeing this video, but whenever this video finds you, that's when it's meant for you. This is a message from your soul. So listen, I was all piped, ready to go, excited. And then all of a sudden, my computer completely crashed, okay? Where I upload my videos. And I tried to say, well, maybe I could just use my iPhone, all of that. But then like, there was no storage, no, it was just chaotic. Like the computer just completely went out, no good, finito. And I was like, oh my goodness. So, you know, I'm like, okay, I'm recording my monthly readings for February, getting y'all guidance to y'all out. You know, I'm doing different things. I'm like uploading personal sessions. I'm like, what in the world? So, you know, needless to say, fast forwarding, I end up having to get a new computer, having to get a new cord, new everything. But this is what I want to, this is the moral of that story, okay? Is this. I didn't realize until I got pushed into a certain place where I had to make some decisions. I probably would have kept working with the computer, but I didn't realize just how aggravating the computer was until it completely went out. It was no good. And I had to, like, you know, take another path, take another step, get another computer, get another laptop. You know what I'm saying? Like, get different things. I didn't realize just how agonizing or how stressful, you know, this thing that I had been doing and working with, you know, just because it, you know, I already had it, you know, it was familiar, or for whatever reason I was keeping it around. God, I don't even realize. I didn't realize just how a nuisance it was until I was forced to, you know, address it. You know, of course, and me addressing it, it was waiting until it was on the last leg and it practically crumbled and I had no choice but to look at it. But once I actually looked at it, once I started to, you know, do the things that I need to do, even though I didn't want to do it. And I'm giving this scenario because if we think about things in our life, okay, things that we truly desire, things that we truly want, paths that we truly want to walk towards, things that we want to walk towards, things that we want to have, create, cultivate in our life. 9 times out of 10, it's going to require us to walk down some paths that at first are going to be uncomfortable. At first, it's going to be, you know, new to us. Anything that's new, it can be uncomfortable. However, your internal guidance system is taking you somewhere, okay? And I feel like this path that you're walking is a path that is unknown. Okay, you might be met with some obstacles, some things that you have to work through, some nuggets like, okay, why is this showing up? You might have to be put in certain positions. You know what I'm saying? Like, I seen a love muffin. I was like, yes, I shouted her out. But she was like, you know, she is working full time, going to school full time. And then after that, you know, she's working on her dreams. Like, she's doing multiple things, okay? She out here grinding. She out here getting it, honey. Yes, you know. And listen, in life and the things that you desire and the things that you are wanting, okay, the universe is asking you a question. This question is right here. But firstly, it says, I follow my inner guidance. What I just feel from this message, just what's radiating from this card in my soul, in my spirit, I really feel whoever is watching this video, your higher self is taking you somewhere, and it's going to require you to be bold. It's going to require you to be courageous. It's going to require you to listen to your inner guidance. The card goes to talk about the 6 faculties of the mind are believed to be reason, memory, perception, will, imagination, and intuition. The mind's faculties are the metaphorical chess pieces which assist in strategically navigating over the chessboard of waking life. It says, through reason, we are able to logically plan and strategize. Like a rook, we can move backwards or forward, left or right, but have the notion to think ahead with logic instead of solely operating with instinct. I always mess that word up, but you know what I mean. It says memory empowers as remembering codes within the DNA of our reasoning, a faculty which dances like the bishop, fully aware and grounding in the notion of contrast. We know what contrast is. Your memory, okay? It can empower your perception. And it says, perception, like a knight, may jump over memory and reason depending on circumstances. So yes, everything is working together. Everything that you have experienced in life, nothing is void. Listen. Oh my God, I just got what Spirit is saying. Listen, all of these things that you have experienced, all of these lessons, they serve a purpose and they are here to help you right now in this very moment. One of the things that I was dealing with a beautiful soul client of mine, and some of these patterns we can be unaware of, consciously or subconsciously. We're aware of them or we're not aware of them, but I was doing a session with her and we got the full card and the hangman. And this is currently the collective energy I'm seeing in just when multiple readings that I'm doing, you know, and within even when my own life, I talked about this and then the new moon in Aquarius video, we are all receiving clarity, vital information from our inner guidance system that is pointing us into a direction that is telling us the path to the desires of our heart. Now, ultimately, you have to make the decision to follow your inner guidance system, the wisdom that you're getting from within, listening to your body. Yeah, you know what? Sometimes we have memory, but sometimes our memory, depending on what we experience, it can be tainted. That's when perception comes in. That's when you go in self-evaluation. Okay, well, am I looking at this from the right way? You know, or do I need to switch it? Do I need to alter? Do I need to change the perception of the way that I'm looking at this? How I'm receiving this download? How I'm looking at this path? You know, because if you have been taught your life to fear the unknown, not to go outside of the box, do not proceed past the exit, or do not enter here sign. There could be a beautiful rose garden on the outside of that sign, but because you've been programmed and this is what you've been around your whole life, you know, you're not going to go to the rose garden, even though it's so beautiful. And this is when our other senses and memory and perception, well, maybe I'm looking at it wrong. Maybe, you know what I'm saying? This is when all of this comes into play and you're getting messages from your inner guidance system. You know, but this beautiful soul client, she pulled the card of the Fool and the Hangman. And this is a decision that we all have to make. Are we going to be bold? Are we going to embody the Fool energy? Or are we going to stay stagnant, stay in the same place? Are you going to stay in the box? You're going to continue to do the same thing, because depending on what that thing is, you know, if it is helping you succeed and helping you build and helping you grow, continue that, because you're going to get more success. You're going to get more abundance. But if this thing is not helping you grow, it's toxic. It makes you feel all of these, you know, unpleasant emotions, these feelings. It's just not healthy for you. You know what I'm saying? Like, I literally had to, you know, look at some situations, because codependency was a big issue for me throughout my life, be it in my friendships, relationships, parentships, ships, all kinds of business ships, all kinds of ships, you know. And the first thing in self, you know, really loving yourself is putting yourself first. And most people that have an issue with codependency, you're usually always the giver, the people pleaser, wanting to make things right, wanting to fix people. And I had to realize, like, I was like, damn, I didn't even realize that it was like seeping up. You know, I was shown something. I was like, now I can continue this pattern, or I could catch myself and see, like, you know what? We're not doing this. We're not doing this. Okay. But yeah, I had a situation like that. And usually people that are codependent or people pleaser, 9 times out of 10, you just have a giving heart, and it's nothing wrong with giving, but everything has to be in balance. Okay. And, on top of, with the codependent issues that I had, I'm an empath. I feel on a whole nother level, you know? So naturally, people with big hearts desire to see everyone happy, desire to see people just out here getting it, realizing that prosperity is for everybody. But one of the things that I had to realize is that I have to allow people to be on their journey and experience what it is that they need to experience. Even when, you know, I see beautiful souls, you know, that I work with or that I don't work with, I always have to remind myself of that, because naturally I know what, you know, it feels like to be in a dark space. I know what it feels like to be lost. And I know, you know, certain tools that can bring you out of this place. So naturally you just want everyone to get it, but you have to realize it's not meant for that. And I learned a valuable lesson in that. You know, I don't know why I'm sharing that, but anyways, we all have a decision to make. Okay. Now I know why I'm sharing that. We all have a decision to make. When you see certain things that are working, okay, or even not working, you have a responsibility to yourself, and your intuition, your inner guidance system is speaking to you, okay? And right now, I really feel like you are embarking on a journey. This journey is unknown. This journey is, you know, not familiar. And for all of us, that can look different. For some, it's you just standing in your personal power, knowing your worth, knowing what you deserve, actually taking the initiative to go after that, pursue that relentlessly. And say that word right, but y'all know what I mean. Okay, but this is what spirit wants you to know. Your soul wants you to know, I'm speaking to you. Okay. Whatever you need, whatever question you have is within you. You'll know by your emotions. You'll know what's for you. You'll know, you know, what's not for you. And for, you know, what I'm hearing is honor that. Honor your internal guidance system. Because when you do, this is when you get the results that you desire, the things that you want. But you have to honor. And sometimes, even with this red right here, you know, honoring yourself, your internal guidance system is going to pull you away from maybe everything that you knew. Because this red is looked like a root chakra, your old foundation. But it's time, you've maybe outgrown that foundation. It's time to do something new. It's time to look at something new. A venture awaits you is what I'm hearing. And how you get this adventure, or, you know, take this path, is by listening to your inner guidance, listening to yourself, okay? Because the next card that came out, guys, was, I'm not even going to pretend to mess up this bird, the falcon, I know that, but it says, seize the moment in life and love or lose it forever. Right now, you have a moment to cultivate and create, self-create what it is that you want out of life. Ask yourself this question. What is it that you want for your life? Go down every category, be it business, career, family, love. What is it that you want for yourself? Okay. Seize the moment in life and love or lose it forever. Sometimes we have to embody that, you know, that, listen, here it is. You're having a golden opportunity to have the desires of your heart, cultivate what it is that you want in your life. You're being presented with a lesson. You're being presented with a situation to exercise where you listen to your inner guidance system. This is how you build your relationship with yourself. Okay? You're being asked that right now. How do you seize the moment? How do I seize the moment? Okay, in life, in love, like, how do I do that? By listening to your inner guidance system. Yourself is talking to you, honey. It's talking to you fluently. It's about being courageous enough to listen. That's what it's about. Are you going to be courageous enough to listen to what your intuition, you know, what your internal, all of yourself is speaking to you about? All right. So we talked about perception, and then it talks about imagination is king. The creative potential, which allows us to build our castle in the sky through the power of the mind's eye. Visualize the life that you want. What do you want for yourself? What do you want when it comes to love? What do you want love to feel like? You know, what do you want for yourself? What do you want for your business? What do you want for your children? First, you have to get clear. When you get clear, that's when the universe can work. But you got to get clear on what it is that you want for yourself, what it is that you want for your life. And you also have to be willing to let go of what's not serving you or what was good for this point in time, like that damn computer. And it was on its last leg and I seen it, but I kept trying to use it, kept trying to revive it until it finally left out. And then I had to go another way. And I'm like, oh my God, I didn't realize how much stress or how much, you know, just that was causing on me. Sometimes we can be afraid to start over, but that's what you truly need. You need to start over. Sometimes we keep reviving situations that are dead. It's gone. It's done. Let it go. That's what someone's intuition is like, literally asking them, can we let this go? Can we stop going through this cycle, baby? Listen, I'm telling you, you got enough. You know what you need to do. Just follow through with it. Let's let this cycle go. Okay. And then after imagination, we have intuition as the universal language of feeling, the senses of emotion and insight. It says foresight met with strategy. Intuition is conjunction with all other working parts of the conscious mind, bringing total awareness. Okay, and through cultivation of awareness, the ideal of inner guidance, we are led to a deepening of awareness of self and the self's strategic relationship to the totality of it all. Guided intuition. What is yourself saying to you? Because depending if you are listening to yourself, you have an opportunity to seize the moment in life and love or lose it forever. And I don't, what is you will always be for you. But my thing is, you have a grand opportunity. It might have to come through another situation. It might have to come through another person. It might have to come through, you know, another, but there is a grand moment here. You can seize it now. Why wait? Why wait? When right now, the ground is fertile. Okay. The tree is ripe. It's good for picking. Let's get it now. So this is a question that yourself is asking you. We have the Seven of Wands coupled with the Two of Cups. What are you willing to fight for? Are you willing to fight for what you love? What brings you joy? Okay. Are you willing to do the work? And the Seven of Wands, it talks about victory, but look at these six wands down here. You're going to get victory, but it comes with contrast. And Abraham Hicks talks about this all the time. Contrast is that shit that we don't like to feel. You know, the nitty gritty, the dirty. You know what I'm saying? The, oh my God, here we go. But in the midst of that, there is a power. You know, there is an energy to create what it is that you do want. When you get something you don't want, you know what you do want. You know, sometimes you got to go through, you know, like you got to feel the shit to get to the sugar. It's okay. But ask yourself, are you willing to do what it takes? Any mean necessary? That's like how You got to become about yourself so serious. Like, listen, I'm not willing. Like, I'm not willing to sacrifice my love. I'm not willing to sacrifice my desires. I'm not willing to sacrifice my needs anymore. Okay? And that's what I feel like what's going on. And again, we got this energy of Aquarius. It's potent, it's ripe. It's here. Very emotional. Okay, very in tune. But listen, happy. When you do that, this is what's going to come into your life. Happy when you listen to yourself, when you follow your we got the fates. It's fated. It's written in the stars. And you know what's crazy, guys? On the bottom of this deck, I seen the star card right here. And the star card is a gift. It is. But before you can get to this gift, there's an ending. There's a deep healing that you know, that's going to take place right here. A mending. And I feel like this mending is with yourself, you and you, the relationship you have with you, getting clear on what it is that you want for your life. It says a change in the wind. Right here, a change in the wind. And in the midst of that, do y'all see that face right here? So I feel like maybe you thought something was going a certain way. Okay. You know, sometimes we have things set in stone. We don't understand why it happened. You know, and even this, a change in wind, this looks almost chaotic, even though I don't know why, like, I'm just seeing like chaos or just like a swift, but you know, some change, but it probably didn't feel good. But I promise you, it's leading you into the right direction. Just how that computer crashing on me. It's leading in you into the right direction. It's taking you somewhere meaningful. It's taking you to a happy place. It's providing healing. Okay? Look at this. We got the Devil card. The Queen of Swords. Okay? Also, the Nine of Swords and the Temperance. Breaking change, breaking cycles, breaking things that aren't good for you. Okay? For some of you, I feel like this is a physical person or a cycle that you've been in with a person. That I feel like it's time to cut. It's time to sever the cords. And that can be hard, you know? But I feel like that's your freedom right there. Okay? You know, and I deal with a lot of beautiful souls that are like on a twin flame journey. And this is why I say what I say. This is not for everybody. But you know, if you're on that journey and it's just too much, it's just too intense. That's why we have separation. That's why separation is very potent, because listen, you have your journey. You get what I'm saying? Your person has their journey and you have a journey together, you know? And I feel like sometimes, you know, it's good to disconnect from people, places, situations. It's not the right time for that. You know? I see this card as healing too. You know, right here, you see these Two of Cups. Temperance, taking time. Like with this Nine of Swords and this Temperance here, this doesn't have to even be a relationship. It could be, you know, because when I see swords, I see mental. Maybe the way that you perceive a relationship or how you show up in relationships. But even with your finances, you know, you're ending some kind of cycle. I know that it might be intense, but listen to your intuition. Okay, because anytime that you see many swords, you mean you're nearing a completion. We got 9, 10, it's almost done. Okay. And then for some, it's done. It's just that, you know, it's the cycle is done. You're out of some kind of cycle. You're ending it. You freed yourself right here with this Queen of Swords and this Devil card. However, whatever was unhealthy, a way that you thought, you know, a way that you've seen things, it could be people, places, relationships, just you doubting yourself, you know, whatever. It's done. You know, sometimes it just takes a little time for the, you know, after the storm, you know, you just, there's some things that just have to get put back into, you know, put back in. But I feel like right now your intuition is moving, taking you away from anything that, you know, really brings discord in your life. And sometimes that can be family, friends, loved ones, lovers. It don't matter. Business partners. And, you know, it might be a time where it'll be a season for that. But right now it's not. It's a season for you to really focus in on yourself. You know, move away from the thoughts, the beliefs of how you perceive your money. You know, limiting yourself on ideas and where you can go and what you can do. Moving away from that because right now you have an opportunity. Seize the moment in life and love. Life and love. All of the above is available for you right here in this now. It's available for you. Pull more. I like these cards. Don't use them much, but I like these. Let's see what else. What else does Spirit want to say? It says, renew the bonds of true friendship and remember their importance. Listen, again, like I told you, whatever is meant for you will come back and around. You can't mess something up that is meant for you to experience in this time. It will come back around. My thing is make sure that you're healed. Make sure that you have dealt whatever this devil situation is. Because like I said, I felt relationships, friendships, it don't matter. Make sure that you're focusing on you, that you're mending whatever it is, you know, that you need to mend within yourself. Because that's one of the things that I talked about in this Aquarius new moon. Instead of looking at what other people did wrong or what, look at yourself. How did you add to the situation? And I'm telling you, that might be a hard truth for somebody. You know, I was talking to my mom, you know, talking to my mother. You know, look at that. Eight of Pentacles, working on yourself. I always talk about my mother, guys, because, you know, I have literally had the honor to watch this amazing woman change her life for the better. Really heal her inner demons and really be who she is at her core. I watched, you know, I've talked about it, you know, my childhood, and I've, you know, watched her just evolve into this, the amazing woman that she was always at her core. And, you know, when you're changing and when you're vibing up and when you're doing that, it's going to be certain family members, friends, relationships that you just outgrow. Okay. And my mom is so nice and so sweet. That's where I get it from. And sometimes there's like this particular family member that, you know, she goes around and just loves to like throw up her past and just this person just can't perceive my mother as the woman that she is today, you know? And one of the things that, you know, I had to, you know, I was talking to my mom. I said, listen, baby, just where you are, you know, where you are, who you are. You don't have to explain your spiritual beliefs, what you're doing to anybody. You don't have to try to make them comfortable in it. And, you know, me being the Sagittarius, you know, I'm just like, mom, just listen. And I'm hearing my mother talk and I'm, you know, hearing her and she just made a decision not to be around this person or just work with this person. And, you know, those people that try to like, they're just so rude and malicious, but they try to cover it in like niceness, not knowing that people can see through that, you know. You know what I'm saying? Just crazy, just craziness. Like doesn't want to come in my mom's house because of crystals and, you know, just people that you know, I'm just like, okay, yeah. So, you know, I was just telling my mom, like, listen, sometimes people are mirrors for you. Okay. Mirrors of what you need to change in yourself and mirrors of you have changed and why the hell are you still accepting this? And in my mother's case, it was you have changed. Why the hell are you still subjecting yourself to people and their ways? Because honestly, like, you know, I again, like I told my mom, I was like, you know, listen, That has nothing to do with you. That same energy where people critique people and judge people and just do all this notion, that's because they're unhappy with their self. If they took the same time to look within their self, heal their inner demons, lose some weight, love who they are, be the best you, oh my God. It would be so amazing, okay? And believe me, y'all, I'm giving y'all the lighter version that I gave my mom. But I told her, like, listen, mommy, you've changed, you know? And you can't keep subjecting yourself to, you know, the stuff that you have outgrown. You know what I'm saying? Like, no. People are mirrors for you. Mirrors of shit that maybe you need to look at yourself and change, and then ask yourself, mirrors as, why do I keep subjecting myself to this kind of behavior? No. You get what I'm saying? Either way, it's a mirror. And that's a valuable lesson, you know, that that I feel like we've all at some point of our life are going to have to look at. And that's maybe what this moment is asking you. You know, look at everything as an opportunity to grow you, to stretch you, to show you what you are no longer, and to inspire you to what you want to be. Bottom of this deck, okay? Be independent. Look to the future and thrive, okay? Listen, you lack nothing. You are a self-creator. Self-creator. You create what it is that you want. Let me tell you something. When I started to follow my inner guidance system, when I started to do that, yes, there was responsibility. And that kind of responsibility, you know, sometimes we're afraid of that responsibility. But I promise you, when you embrace that you are in control, that you take full responsibility for when shit goes right and when shit goes left. But anyways, when shit go left, don't go with it. Remember that, okay? It'll bounce back. But when you take full responsibility for that, when you acknowledge that, man, that takes courage. That is power. That is the ticket to success, is responsibility. Because believe it or not, there are a lot of, you know, souls that just don't want that responsibility. Doing the work. Are you willing to put in the work? Are you willing to take responsibility? Do what it is that you got to do. Be up against what you got to be up against for the victory. Read those books. Listen to those affirmations. Journal. Manifest it. Pray. What? Trust, open up, be vulnerable. Are you willing to do it? Are you willing to look at yourself? Look at this, these unhealthy habits, you know? One of the things that I was talking with my sister, and you know, actually I was talking to a love muffin. I met Sylvia, we had pizza. It was so beautiful. It was so great. Oh my gosh, she is such a beautiful soul. But we were having conversations, you know, and I had this conversation with Love Muffin, but also my sister right here about, you know, being intuitive and, you know, and we all have gifts. We all have an intuition. We all can see beyond the veil. I'm trying to tell you, it's nothing. You know what I'm saying? Like, we all have this. It's just who choose to operate in it, who choose to work with it and strengthen that, you know, and I be strengthening the shit out of mine. And, you know, to, you know, walk in a room and just know every story, you know, I had to learn boundaries with that because at the end of the day, you know, I can't tackle it all. I can't, you know, insert myself in every person's life and every situation and bring that on as my own. That's a no-no, you know? Moving past whatever this is, whether it's a belief and it's really rooted in the foundation, you know, a belief or your perception or how you're perceiving a situation, you know? One of the things that my sister was talking about is that she wants to love her children from a healthy love, you know, because being her childhood of having to fend and, you know, do this for herself, it brought on this need to want to protect and, you know, shield her children. And even that became, you know, a little unhealthy. And she had to realize that I was loving them from an unhealthy place. I was loving them in that fear and that doubt. And that's the energy that you're carrying out there. So she had to change that. But first she had to go within herself, you know, and look at some things and mend some things within her heart. And you can use this in every category of your life, be it in love, be it in career, within yourself. It doesn't matter. But your intuition is speaking to you. It's asking you an important question. Okay? So, my love muffins, I hope that this brought you some clarity, some understanding. I hope that it got you excited for where your life is headed. As always, it was such an honor to read for the beautiful soul who is watching this video. I love you oodles and oodles of much, and I will catch you on my channel. Take care. She blazing.